Okay, this question is going to trick so many people, especially when you present it like this. First, we know that sine theta is in between of negative 1 and 1, and cosine theta is also in between of negative 1 and 1. So now the question is, what if we add them up? Sine theta plus cosine theta is going to be in between of what and what? It looks really easy, right? Because we add the middle, so we should just add this and that, which is negative 2. And then we add this and that, which is just 2. But if you do this, it's not going to be correct. Why? Because when sine theta is equal to 1, that theta value is not going to make cosine equal to 1. Yeah, have a look. Sine, let's say pi over 2. This right here will give us 1. But if you plug in pi over 2 into cosine, that's actually going to give us 0. And the reason is because, just look at the unit circle real quick. It's also over there. Anyways, pi over 2 is 90 degrees, which is right here. This coordinate is 0, 1. Cosine is the x value, which will have 0. Sine is the y value, which is 1. So does this mean, though, when we add these two together, it's just 1 plus 0, so the answer right here is 1, and over there should be negative 1, so same thing like the original? Not that either. So what should we do though? Let me show you. Here, when we have sine theta plus cosine theta, in fact, we can write this into just one single sine function or a one single cosine function, but the amplitude is going to change. However, that's why it's going to help us find out the answer. So what I mean by that is the following. We can actually write this as some number, usually we put it down as capital R, and let's use sine. Sine of, we still have to have the angle theta, but we have to modify the angle a little bit. We are just going to add another angle, that's a phi. And our goal is to figure out what r and phi will be so that this and that are identical. To make this happen, we can use the angle sum identity to expand sine of this part. So that will be sine of the first times cosine of the second. And then we add cosine of the first times sine of the second. This is how you can remember it. And then multiply r with this. So we will have to multiply the r right here and then r right here. Now, why do we do that though? Because the first part has sine theta right here. So that means we better have r times cosine phi to be this coefficient, which is just equal to 1. So that's our first condition, and let's go ahead and write that down. We must have r times cosine phi to be 1. Now, secondly, we do the same thing. Here we have r times sine phi. That must be the coefficient for cosine theta, and that's going to be 1 right here as well. So we have another condition that r times sine phi has to be 1. Now, there are equations. What we can do is just divide. This divided by that, and this divided by that. This is okay for equations. And when we do that, r just cancel out. And of course, r cannot be 0 because otherwise, that would be 0. Cosine phi over sine phi, that's cotangent phi. 1 over 1, just 1. And now we just have to find angle phi to make this true, which is the same as saying 1 over tangent is equal to 1, so that means tangent should be 1, and phi being 45 degrees, which is pi over 4, will do the job. Now, how do we find the r though? We have phi already, just plug back into the first or the second equation. Let's do the first one. R times cosine phi, which is pi over 4. Okay, this right here is 1 over square root of 2. Now, multiply both sides by square root of 2, r is equal to square root of 2. So, what we have done so far is that this is going to be the same as r, which is square root of 2, times sine of theta plus phi, which is pi over 4. Yeah, they are identical. Very cool, huh? Now, per our discussion earlier, sine of anything, the output is always going to be in between of negative 1 and 1. Now, we're just going to multiply that by square root of 2. So, the answer to our question earlier, when we have sine theta plus cosine theta, in fact, the smallest value that we can get is negative square root of 2. And then the biggest value that we can get is positive square root of 2. That finishes the question. That's it.